Welcome to this brief guide on how to use Markdown in Google Docs. Google Docs has many hidden and little-known features that can help make your document creation easier than ever. And so today I'm going to introduce you to Markdown support natively in Google Docs. Here you can see I have the Google Docs homepage open, and I could start by creating a blank document, but in my particular case here, I already have a document called What is Markdown, and so I'm going to open up that existing document. And here, you can see my document is currently empty, and so I'd need to start it off with a lovely little heading. And normally what a lot of people would do is head to the Text Styles option, and then select from the options for things such as Heading 1, Heading 2, or possibly even Heading 3. However, there's an easier way that we can do this using nothing more than our keyboard through the support of Markdown. To enable Markdown support, we need to head to the Tools menu in our toolbar, and then we need to select the option for Preferences. Selecting this will have our preferences open in a pop-up window, as you can see here, and the Automatically Detect Markdown option is not currently enabled. So in order to activate this, we simply tick the checkbox and then select the option for OK to apply this change. And now we have Markdown support ready to be used. So what sort of things can we do with Markdown? The first thing that we can do is activate certain font styles. So by typing in a pound sign followed by the space, you can see that I have now been able to trigger Heading 1. And I'm going onto a new line, and I'll type in 2 pound signs followed by a space. And you guessed it, this will give us Heading 2. So now I can easily type into my second font format without needing to take my hands away from the keyboard. But if I was to head to my font styles, what you'll see is that I have options for headings 1, 2, and 3. However, Google Docs does support more than this. In fact, they support all the way up to 6 different heading styles. So if I was to type in 6 pound signs followed by a space, you'll see that this feature works all the way up to heading 6. Now this is really nifty because of the fact that it wasn't an option for me in that menu originally. However, there's something to note as well here. Now that I've activated heading 6, if I head back to that font styles, I now have options for headings 4, 5, and 6 showing up in that context menu because they have now been used in my document. But Markdown support in Google Docs can also do a lot more, such as things like hyperlinks. So normally if I wanted to insert a hyperlink into my document, I would type in my text that I would like it to display, highlight my text, and then utilize the right click menu and activate the option that says insert link from the context menu. Or if I'm used to keyboard shortcuts, I would use the keyboard shortcut Command or Control K. However, there's an easier way to do this using Markdown as well. We can simply enter in the text that we would like to be displayed inside some brackets, and then follow it up with parentheses in our URL. The thing to note here is that it is essential that you do not include a space between the brackets and the parentheses, otherwise this will not work. But once I've entered in my details, I hit space, and as you can see, my hyperlink is now created inside my document. And if I wanted to, I could click on the link just to test it and make sure that it's working. And as you can see, it's taken you straight to my bento page. Feel free to give it a look and follow me around the web if you'd like. As you can see, we've now done font styles and hyperlinks, but what else can we do with the power of Markdown? Well, it turns out that we can cover a couple of our primary formatting options, such as bold and italic, utilizing keyboard commands in Markdown. The first of which is to utilize an asterisk. So if I was to bookend a piece of text with an asterisk on either end, what you'll see is that this text is going to become italic. So after I enter in that asterisk at the end, my text automatically changes to italics. I'm not limited to just using asterisks though. If you prefer, you can also use an underscore at the end of either part of your text, and you will get the same effect with a single underscore. And so that's how we get our italics, but what happens if we wanted bold text? Well, that's easy enough to do just by simply using two asterisks, and so bookending our text on either side with double asterisks will give us our bold text. And there we go. And just like you'd expect as well, we can replace those two asterisks with two underscores on either side and have the same effect occur as well. And then now I'm hearing you ask, what happens if we utilize three? Well, let's try it out and find out. So if we enter in three asterisks on either side, we can use those to combine both bold and italics at the same time. So this is really easy for us to be able to get either bold, italics, or bold and italics without needing to take our hands away from the keyboard. But we're not done yet. Last, but certainly not least, is the tilde key. Utilizing the tilde key to bookend our text on either side will give our text a strike-through appearance, super useful in certain circumstances. Now, I'm aware that Markdown does support things such as code blocks, but at the time of this recording, Google Docs did not support that feature. Hopefully it comes in the near future. But for now, we can easily access our formatting, font styles, and even create hyperlinks using our keyboard and the power of Markdown. I hope you found this tip extremely useful and it makes your document creation just that much easier in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.